Hello, I'm KCRA3 meteorologist Dirk Verdoorn, and welcome to this Facebook Live. We're talking about the week ahead and the big changes that are coming this way. It's been really interesting to see. We've had 2 weeks in a row where these cold systems have come through and dropped some low snow and brought some rain to our area. It's been feeling more like winter than it has like spring, and then we get the spring that kind of sandwiched in between these cold systems that have been dropping down from the north. This one that's currently been going through this weekend, this Saturday and Sunday, where we had literally 2 days of record cold maximum temperatures. So we had on Saturday a morning temperature, this was before the sun came up, that got up to 59 degrees, and then it was cooler throughout the day. So our daytime temperature stayed in the 40s for much of the day on Saturday. That's a pretty cold day. Even by winter standards, we had snow levels that dropped down between 2,000 to 3,000 feet. And then we've had this weather system that came in. Well, at least it's still the same system, but it's just rotated through today. We've had the core of it go through, and it's brought some more scattered rain showers and some more snow. And we're still seeing it even at this time where we're still getting some snow. Snow levels have risen up a bit. We're looking at snow levels now between 4,000 to 5,000 feet, but still some areas of rain and snow. And it's eventually going to clear out. So let's go ahead and take a look at this and what's been going on. Here it is. It's been slowly working its way from the coast of California yesterday. It's made its way across and into, well, you can kind of see the center of it. It almost looks like it's kind of got two little circulation points now. You can see the flow kind of coming around here. You've got this coming in here, and then you've got this spinning around up here. And so this is all going to be moving off towards the east. And as this does so, we're going to get a little bit of a north breeze as we go into Monday. And then we will be warming up. We're going to notice some of that warming tomorrow. We're still going to be, I think, a little bit below average with temperatures in the upper 60s to lower 70s. And then we're going to see temperatures climbing into the mid to upper 70s by Tuesday. And then we should be in the 80s by Wednesday. But getting back here, this is just interesting, so let's take a look at it. So we've got this cold air coming in, and you can see here, look at all this instability. So you definitely have some colder air aloft, and you've got some warmer air that's just kind of coming into that, and that's why you're getting all these thunderstorms now popping up in through Oregon, and it looks like portions of, well, not really Idaho, it looks like it's all in Oregon right now. So you got that line of thunderstorms. And we got some intense cells, but not as intense as you would think they would be, considering we've got some lightning strikes associated with them. But that's all going on in Oregon. We're not expecting that here in California. In fact, we're going to get, again, that air that's going to be dropping down from the north. And so what happens there is as the air is driving in from the north, it's actually sinking. It's becoming more stable. And that's why we're seeing these showers that are coming down from the north kind of dissipating. We're seeing it just kind of fade away. So we had this batch of rain making its way from Tehama County through Glenn County, Colusa County, and then once it's gotten into Sutter and portions of, well, Yuba's still going to get a pretty good rain, but it's just dissipating. It's all just kind of fading away. We're seeing kind of a mess in Plumas County moving south, and that's holding together pretty good. So we got this little batch of energy that's driving still some rain out and some snow as it makes its way over the Sierra, moving from the northern Sierra. It's going to go through the central Sierra. And we're just going to have to wait and see if it really holds together. Computer models are saying that it is going to hold together, so we could see some snow as far south as Tuolumne County and farther south. But it looks like the rain's just kind of given out. So my hopes for some more measurable rainfall looks like it's going to be pretty weak there. That doesn't look like it's going to happen. So that's what's going on right now. Let's go ahead and take a look at what's expected tonight and in the future. Here we go with Futurecast. You can see we have some cloud cover kind of dissipating. So let's go back here. This is where we are. Currently, that rain looks like, I mean, it's forecasting that it's going to hold together. Just looking at the radar, it's not likely. It's possible, but it's not likely. And then it has it holding together as it go through San Joaquin County, and then even a little bit into Stanislaus County. Tuolumne County looks like you're going to get a good chance of that snow holding together in the upper elevations, but again, not a lot of rain as this moves down tonight and into tomorrow. Now, what's going to happen tomorrow morning? Look at this. The clouds all dissipate. Now, if that happens, then we're going to have some cooling. We're going to have some radiational cooling. That means the heat's going to escape the earth at a more rapid rate. And that's going to allow the possibility of some low clouds and fog to develop in the valley. And so that's what's showing up here. So you can see where we have that just stretching down from Placer County through Sacramento County, San Joaquin and Stanislaus County. That's an area of low clouds and some fog that could develop for your Monday morning. So don't be shocked if there's some fog. Be grateful if there's not. That'll be nice if you don't have the fog. But if you're in one of these spots that does see some fog, just be prepared. Give yourself some extra time and get going tomorrow morning. It shouldn't last long. We've got a little bit of a north breeze that's going to help to drive that out. And then we'll see a few clouds as we go through the early afternoon. But by late afternoon, here we are, 4 and 5 o'clock. Looks like it's going to be fairly sunny. It should be pretty nice as we go through your Monday late afternoon and on into the evening hours. Sun goes down and the clouds all disappear. More clouds come in on Tuesday, but no rain expected, and temperatures will continue to warm through Tuesday. We'll continue to see those temperatures climbing on Wednesday, even though we are going to see more in the way of cloud cover as we go through Wednesday afternoon. So we should be in the 80s by this point. So that's what we're expecting. So here's the bigger picture showing you this weather pattern. Again, this pocket of cold air, that's why we had the rain showers on Sunday. And of course, the low snow on Saturday, that's moving out, and it's going to make its way from Nevada on into Utah. So they're going to see a big drop in temperatures, especially sitting at between, you know, 4,000 and 5,000 feet. You get up there, Salt Lake's over 4,200 feet. That's going to bring some cold temperatures to that area, and on and over the Rockies and into Colorado, Denver. Also, again, Mile High City is going to have some cold temperatures. Could get some snow out of it. While California, we're going to be warming up. We got those temperatures that'll be climbing. Again, by tomorrow, we'll be in the upper 60s to around 70 degrees. And then we'll see those temperatures in the 70s and then 80s by Wednesday. And then it looks like it's going to stay this way. We have weather systems, some colder air staying to the north. Well, we're looking pretty good, especially Southern California. You're going to be feeling the heat there in the southern part of the state. But pretty nice in Northern California. Again, that cold air masses, they keep on pushing into the Pacific Northwest, but it looks like they're going to stay more to the north. And so as we get into next week, we'll continue with this nice pattern. So through this week, it looks pretty good. And on into the following week, this takes us all the way through April 24th. So it looks like for the month of April, there's not going to be a lot going on as far as rain chances. In fact, let's go ahead and take a look at this. This is another computer model that we have, and this is showing us where we are currently. Area of low pressure with a chance for rain. Here comes the high pressure moving in. Yeah, we'll see some clouds here and there, but this is going to continue to grow. And it's going to continue to affect our weather as we go through this week and towards next weekend. Look at that Saturday. We have a little weather system that wants to bring some rain, but it just breaks apart. So it's looking pretty good that we're going to be dry through next weekend. And so temperatures are going to be staying on the warmer side. In fact, it looks like we're going to be above average temperatures for a good portion of this coming week. It's hard to believe since many of us have our heaters running right now because it's so cold outside. But here's your 7-day forecast. And here's a look at the numbers. So you can see we're getting up the upper 60s to around 70 degrees on Monday. We will see some cloud cover again through the early afternoon, but then it's going to clear out. Tuesday, call it mostly sunny, temperatures in the mid to upper 70s, and then we get up into the low 80s by Wednesday with a few more clouds. Thursday looking pretty good. That could be the warmest day of the week, and then we're staying in the upper 70s to lower 80s through Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So again, no rain in the forecast. Daytime highs will be warming up. Overnight temperatures will be cooling, but not as cold as they have been. So the forecast is looking fairly dry and fairly warm as we go through this coming week. So that's what we have to look forward to. If you're looking forward, if you got that taste of spring, because we have had some warm weather. We got into the 80s. It looks like we have more coming for you if you like that kind of weather. So conditions are looking pretty good. Our minds are going to be turning from the snow and from the, you know, mountains and the snowy weather to jumping in the water maybe with the 80 degree temperatures. It's still way early though. The water is going to be very cold, so I would not recommend going in any open waters. If you have a pool you want to jump in, yeah, that's fine. But it looks like the weather is going to be turning for the warmer, so hopefully you'll be able to enjoy that. Get out and do some spring gardening. Get ready for the season. So that's about it. Hopefully this has been helpful for you. Hopefully you can plan your week accordingly. It looks like it's going to be a great week to get out and do something, whether you want to enjoy the nice weather on a hike, a bike, just enjoy the outdoors, or just do stuff around the house. The lawn's going to be going crazy, especially after the rains that we just had, so you may be caught up in doing some yard work there. But thanks for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful week ahead.